Hello, my name's Mr. Smith, and I think one of the greatest films of the last few years is The Fantastic Mr. Fox. It was released in 2009, directed by Wes Anderson, and you might be wondering why I'm stood out in the woods here to tell you this. Well, one of the great things about the film is that it's got an amazing cast. It's got George Clooney, it's got Meryl Streep, it's got Jason Schwartzman, who played one of the evil exes in Scott Pilgrim. But part of the way they got the cast just to be really natural, which is a bit different from some animated films, I think, is they actually took them out into the countryside to record some of the dialogue. So in most animated films, they're in a studio and sometimes they're overacting and it sounds a bit kind of fake. But in The Fantastic Mr. Fox, then they actually were out at a farm, outdoors, while they were recording the sound. Another thing that I really like about it is the type of animation. It's a type of animation called stop-motion animation, which is the same as the way The Corpse Bride was made. So that means that they take puppets, they move them one frame at a time, take pictures, and it turns it into a film, which takes ages and ages. And it actually looks a little bit old-fashioned now, and some of the figures and some of the animation in Mr. Fox looks a bit old school, but it's actually really, really hard to do, and the puppets are really hard to make. They actually had to go to such a level of detail, they actually made each tooth for each fox individually, and they made them out of sterling silver because they were just snapping when they were made out of plastic. So every single tooth was made out of silver, painted white. Also, the hairs, each of the hairs had to be dyed, and they're actually goat's hairs on the foxes. And if you watch really carefully, you can tell where the animators have touched some of the characters, because as it's animated, the kind of hair seems to change direction. So that's why I've chosen Mr. Fox. I just think it's a bit different, it's a bit more laid back. It's definitely not a kid's film, and if you haven't seen it, I would highly recommend it. And here's the trailer.
So it begins.
Welcome to the fantastic world of Mr. Fox.
Woo!
Should we dance?
Ah, woo-hoo!
His life is fantastic.
Pure wild animal craziness.
His wife is fantastic.
If what I think is happening, it better not be.
His neighbors, not so fantastic.
This is Bogus, Bunce, and Bean, three of the meanest, nastiest, ugliest farmers in his valley.
What was that?
They're digging us out.
But they're about to discover...
Oh, Foxy, is help on the way?
He's one fox.
I've got an idea.
You can't outfox.
Mole, what do you got?
I can see in the dark.
We can use that.
Rabbit, I'm fast.
Badger,
demolitions expert.
What? Since when? Here, put these bandit hats on.
I don't have a bandit hat, but I modified this tube sock.
They look good.
Yeah, we do.
The only security is if old hunting beagles laced some blueberries with sleeping powder. Beagles love blueberries. Titanium card.
What's this thing you do, the whistle with the clicking sound?
That's my trademark.
We're different. We all are. Him especially. But there's something kind of fantastic about that, isn't there?
I can fight my own fight.
No, you can't.
I guess we should start doing something, right?
Let's see some hustle.
Yeah! Woo!
This fall, forget Super.
That was close, Rat.
Be careful.
Oh, I'm as careful as a...
Ignore Incredible.
I can fit through there. You want to know why? Why? Because I'm little.
It's all about fantastic.
You really are fantastic.
I try.
Fantastic Mr. Fox.
What's this lightning bolt?
This fence might be electric.
Well, I just hope it doesn't mean thunder, because I have a phobia of that.
Get Milky in!